Well, I'd had some experience with this in the preparations at the State Department with the avian influenza. And separately, the World Bank has been part of an international effort to try to prepare for these events. And you've seen the discussions from the WHO about what you can try to do at a precautionary level for individuals, but also share the information. And this is very important, and I think I talked with Margaret Chan, the head of WHO, right, just 2 days ago. The United States has done a pretty good job of trying to capture the information about the virus, to learn more about it, take the various action. Obviously, what we've tried to do in various places is to stock Tamiflu and other different supplies. But where we as an institution can be helpful, and Mexico is a good case, is that when this information sort of broke over a couple days ago, I was at these big spring meetings. I met with the Mexican finance minister, and we had the ability to reallocate $25 million like that to be able to help them get some of the basic health care supplies and basic medicines. And over a course of another 3 weeks, we could do about another $180 million. So we want countries to be able to have the resources to take the actions in their own health care systems. We had one of our people, it appears, we haven't had it totally confirmed yet, came down with swine flu. Fortunately, the individual recovered very quickly. This was before he'd come back from Mexico and had just regular antibiotics. So, you know, what I think everybody's hoping for is that while this has spread, the virulence of it, the sharpness of it, has not yet so strong, so people are able to recover.